Stay tuned until the end of the video for info about future content. Also, if I sound kind of weird, it's because I have a cold right now. We return to Babylon 5 with the TV movie and backdoor pilot, A Call to Arms, and I don't really like it. 5 years after the formation of the Interstellar Alliance, President Sheridan is supervising the launch of two prototype starships when he becomes aware of a threat from Servants of the Shadows who are planning an attack on Earth. But the eventual resolution of the story would have been completed in the spin-off series Crusade, which we'll talk about later. I have to say that Crusade's omens were not good after this movie because it's pretty subpar. In terms of writing, this movie somehow feels rushed and slow at the same time. A problem in Babylon 5's fifth season was that the Shadow War and President Clark stories just cannot be topped. And the plot of A Call to Arms is the same ancient alien races moving to start a war thing, which we already saw in Babylon 5. But while Babylon 5 had almost three seasons of build-up, fleshing out characters and the inner workings of the universe, A Call to Arms misses out on that great material, feeling thin while also dragging its heels for much of the runtime. Not to mention the Drak are just so generic as bad guys, whereas the Shadows were utterly distinct and terrifying. While characters for Crusade are introduced such as Galen and Darina and do well, the regular cast from Babylon 5 are given very little in terms of interesting material to work with. People think Sheridan may be going crazy for some of it, but that never really pays off. Instead, much of the script is bogged down in exposition. This is especially bad during the introduction of the Excalibur starship, where we just sit back and watch a guy explain the operations of the ship with seemingly no other purpose than padding. And I feel like most of this information could just be conveyed visually anyway when the ship is in use. It feels as if so much could have been cut out, and yet so much is lacking at the same time. The priority in terms of storytelling seems to be to just set up Crusade. There's a lot of plot, but very little story, if you know what I mean. The cast do their best with what they're given, and their personalities and charisma hold some attention. Tony Todd, for example, gets a lot of mileage out of sheer screen presence, despite his character being introduced almost halfway into the film. What undercuts the drama even further is the terrible music score. In my initial video on Babylon 5, I made sure to praise Christopher Franke's music, and it is sorely missing here. Instead, composer Evan H. Chen's strange arrangements completely fail to carry the movie. There's no distinct themes, none of it sounds exciting or dramatic. Instead, the consistent feeling is just vague creepiness, which works for the vaguely creepy scenes, but when you're doing the Enterprise and space dock equivalent scenes or large-scale space battles, I expect something with a little more impact. There's also the weird thing in the end space battle where they have segments which are just completely silent, and instead you just see characters saying the word fire over and over again while the dull music plays over top. This is also something which happened in Crusade, which I'll get to in that video. A lack of character arcs, seen it all before plotting and bad pacing make A Call to Arms a slog to sit through. While this film is a dud, it's Crusade which eventually became the much more interesting failure. Thanks for watching. This was a really quick video this week. I've been super busy working on a short film of mine, but I have plans for more content soon. I'll always have more videos on Star Trek, but I'm also going to get around to Lex at some point, and even Doctor Who, with some revisits to Stargate and discussions on more modern sci-fi content such as The Expanse. Eventually, when Star Trek Discovery Season 1 wraps up, I'll have another podcast about that. I have some other projects coming soon which I'm really excited to talk about, so stay tuned. Until then, have a good one, guys. See ya.